Time triggers for component states aren't available just yet, but let me show you how the end of playback trigger will change the way you prototype in Adobe XD. Here's a robot I've been designing over the last few days, and I'd love to animate this little guy on an app or website mockup, but I certainly don't want several artboards for each movement, which I've set up as various states within this component. Within the default state, I've included a trimmed video that will automatically play once previewed. And with the addition of the end of playback trigger for videos and Lottie animations, we can have this state advance automatically. Switching over to prototype mode, you'll notice the video's time trigger, which kicks off the playback once the prototype loads. And clicking the blue plus button to the right will add on a second interaction. Within the properties inspector, we'll want to choose the end of playback trigger. This will perform the action down below once the video's playback is complete, as long as looping is not enabled. Now, since we'll want the destination state to animate in, the type should be set to auto-animate, and the easing options can be customized to your personal preference. Let's try a fairly quick snap. With the new interaction ready to rock, let's see it in action. Launching the preview will start the video's playback. Then once it completes, the transition to the next state will automatically take place thanks to the end of playback trigger. So, this is all fine and dandy, but seeing that this next state contains no videos or Lottie animations, are we out of luck if we want another automatic transition? Not completely. Knowing that Lottie animations also support the end of playback trigger, I recently thought to myself, what if I hide a very short animation solely for the purpose of advancing states? And that's exactly what we're going to do. Using After Effects, I created this two-frame Lottie animation, which I can either drag or copy and paste into this state. And since we aren't worried about seeing the actual contents of this file, I'll set the opacity at 0. If you want to get your hands on this incredibly complex and totally groundbreaking animation, I'll leave a link in the description and on Twitter. Now that we have our Lottie animation within this state, we'll want to make sure that its playback is set to play automatically and that looping is not turned on. Then, similar to the video example, switching over to prototype mode will allow us to add the end of playback trigger, where the next state can be chosen as the destination and the transition can be customized. For this one, let's try ease in out with a slightly longer duration. Before we take a look at the preview, since our two-frame animation will complete almost instantly, we may want a slight delay before the transition takes place. To accomplish that, we can switch over to the time trigger on this element, then add the delay up top. Somewhere around 0.4 or 0.6 seconds should work well. Finally, I think I may want the last two states to loop between each other. So I'll quickly copy the blank animation and paste it within the last state, making sure that the destination and interaction properties are set accordingly. Perfect. Switching back over to the default state, let's see our completed animation. Like before, the video kicks off when the preview is launched, followed by the transition to the second state. But now, since we added in the hidden Lottie animations, we were able to set up additional transitions to the third, then back to the second. Is this workflow ideal? Probably not. But while we wait for additional time trigger support, at least there's a workaround. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Be sure to subscribe for more content, follow me on Twitter, and I'll see you all next time.